Hi, this is a channel about fundamental physics and maths and the connection between the two. Warning note first, this series are not educational videos explaining well understood concepts, but some hopefully original thoughts. We'll cover the big picture where this is going in a later video. Let's jump right in to try and capture your interest with this question. How would a world with multiple time dimensions appear to its inhabitants? The main trick to handling multiple time dimensions is to step out of the world and look at it from the outside as a static object. Here on the left is a 2D man waving his arm, and then again the same scene on the right, from the outside with the time dimension shown as a space dimension. We can see the whole scene, past and future, as a single static object. This is not very practical and we run out of dimensions quickly, so alternatively we can show frames of spaces next to each other like a film strip. Here again a scene with colored particles. We can extend this to two time dimensions or even three time dimensions. The states of the spaces along the time dimension only change slowly and gradually because each state is calculated from the previous state. In a continuous time system using differential equations and a discrete time system, each space is calculated from the previous time step. For multiple time dimensions, we can easily think of a system where each state depends on multiple predecessors along each time dimension, and we'll show an example later in this video. We all know from thermodynamics that the essence of a time dimension is that statistically disorder increases. The second law of thermodynamics determines which way time flows. A man waving an arm does not really show a time direction because the motion is readily reversible. Here you see that the state of the initial space is highly ordered, indicating which way time flows. Zooming in, you see that the order gradient is less apparent. Since the words entropy or disorder imply a randomness, but we're dealing with deterministic processes, we prefer to use the term complexity instead. We mean an equivalent concept though. If we plot the inverse of complexity against a single time dimension, we get a curve that is heading downwards. If we place a marble on this curve, it will roll down. Imagining a physical marble is helpful in building an intuition when it comes to multiple time dimensions. The sensation of time is a macroscopic phenomenon. After all, you need a system of a certain size in order to observe the general downwards trend towards higher complexity. If we zoom in, we see that the curve is bumpy, so at that scale the time direction is not apparent. With two time dimensions, this plot of complexity becomes the surface of a cone. Again, when we zoom in, the landscape can be bumpy. The steepest slope we'll call a timeline. Throughout these videos, we'll represent a timeline graphically as a fat arrow, with thin arrows indicating the direction of sideways in time. With two or more time dimensions, the timeline is not unique. A marble will roll down the steepest slope, but if you place another marble somewhere else, it will roll down a different path of the same maximum slope. Also, the timelines diverge, making room for more paths in between. With a single time dimension, the number of 3D spaces stays a constant 1 per time coordinate. But with multiple time dimensions, the number of spaces sideways in time increases. Each space depends on the predecessor spaces in other time dimensions, so that means that microscopically particles happily influence each other from sideways in time. However, macroscopic observers have large brains and are made up of complex systems with many microscopic particles, so the event structure becomes a tree. Copies of our observer are constantly spawned off that share a history up to the spawn-off point, so each only remembers that history. So in the subjective experience of each of the observer copies, time appears one-dimensional. The branches of this event tree don't recombine, because brains are big and contain many parts, and it is generally unlikely that all these small parts happen to arrive close to the same state other than by direct descent down that tree. The effect of this tree structure is not a particularly hard to grasp concept. Alternate timelines feature in many movies, and the tree structure is familiar to any computer gamer that has ever reverted to a save point. So then the answer to the question posed by this video is that in a universe with multiple time dimensions, any macroscopic observers would experience time to be one-dimensional. So you might now suspect that this is the hidden thesis here, and you would be right. You might also think that this sounds a bit like the many worlds interpretation of quantum theory, which postulates that the entire universe splits at quantum events. The ideas are certainly related, and multiple time dimensions can explain at least as much as many worlds, but it's also more economical and doesn't double the size of the universe state space each quantum event. Neighboring timelines do interact with each other, and crucially, what we have described are consequences of multiple time dimensions and don't require the postulation of arbitrary laws. And because of these differences, we'll be able to verify this idea experimentally. Here is our observer. He has a body and a mind state. By that we don't mean soul or spirit, but the processing state of his brain. The body and mind are a bit like the hardware and the software of a computer. We'll show the mind state graphically as a cartoon thought bubble. Here we have two timelines with two identical copies of our observer and environment. There are two bodies of the observer, we can count them, but they all share the same mind state. That means that they behave completely in sync with each other. It's the nature of complex systems that introducing a tiny difference very quickly makes the systems diverge drastically. Observers can also share a mind state in non-identical timelines. Here are the two different timelines, but the observers still share the same mind state because the difference is the state of a microscopic particle contained in a box and not known to the observers. The mind state of the observers only diverges when differing information becomes available to them. Now we have the observers also in a box. They share the same mind state. Now the detectors trigger and display the state of the microscopic particle. But this information has not reached the observers yet. When they leave their boxes and see the result, their mind states diverge. But there is another effect, which we can call timeline selection. As we pointed out earlier, each observer must be on a continuous path on the event tree. This way, even just an instrument detecting and recording information about the particle that is available to observer copies has an effect in which subtree the observer can be. Here is the event tree diagram. At this point, the particle is determined to be green or red by the detector. To be clear, we draw the arrows for the subtrees in green and red. At these points in the timeline, the observers are identical and still in the box and ignorant of the state of the particle. Somewhere further down the tree, the observer learns the state of the particle, say red here, marked with a red dot at the bottom right. This means that there are no paths leading to this point on the timeline that have green arrows, only red. It doesn't matter if the observer never checks the state of the particle in most of the timelines. What is required for this timeline selection not to apply is that the particle state information is not available to the whole subtree, either by not collecting it in the first place, or by diligently destroying it after collection so that no observer copies far down the subtree can forensically recover it. Don't get hung up about thinking about effects traveling backwards in time, and remember our resolution to look at the multiple time dimensions from the outside. All that happened is timeline selection. Copies of the observer and the observed particle still exist in all timelines. The particle behavior does not change at all, whether it is measured or not. If the observer believes himself to be the only copy in a one-dimensional time universe and tries an experiment that repeatedly shoots out red and green particle pairs towards detectors, he might conclude that the outcome of the experiment is completely random, with a probability of 50% for each result. And that the particle pairs are somehow entangled, so that observing one instantaneously determines the state of the other. One last example about the effects of multidimensional time. Here we have a simulation with red and blue billiard balls in a box. Same colors repel and opposites attract. Time runs to the right and we show the state of the balls in 12 snapshots. You can see that we start in a maximally ordered state and then complexity increases to the right, so the time direction is apparent. One of the blue balls is shown as black and we track its path with a line. Next, we introduce another time dimension with a similar one time dimensional simulation, this time downwards. There is a very small asymmetry in the initial condition of the down direction, but not in the way that the rest of the grid is calculated. If both T1 and T2 have the same complexity gradient, then the maximum complexity gradient is diagonally between them, as shown here by our symbol for the timeline, which also shows the sideways in time direction. In this next box, the new state is calculated from the average of the state of the box above and the box to the left, as are all the other boxes in this grid. Already we notice something strange. The path of the black ball is no longer a single line. It actually arrived at its location in two different ways. Let's calculate the rest. In each box, you see that the black ball is in a specific place, but has multiple histories how it has arrived there. If our observer finds himself at generation 12 on the diagonal, but has not checked where the black ball is, then the mind states of all 12 observers are identical. When these observers do check the position of the black ball, then their mind states diverge and each finds the black ball in a particular location, but until then they can only make statistical assessments of where the black ball is. Here we plot the 12 positions of a black ball with an opacity of 1/12 on top of each other. If the observer believes to be the only copy in a single time-dimensional world, he may come to the conclusion that the ball is in the probability cloud and only collapses into a real position upon measurement. In summary, we introduce the concept of a timeline, not to be confused with a time dimension. A timeline is the path of steepest complexity increase through the time dimensions. Moving along the time dimensions, the number of timelines and therefore also the number of spaces increases. We've shown that multiple copies of observers living in these spaces share the same mind state, operating in perfect unison in the different bodies, and that the mind states diverge when differing information reaches them. The fact that observers are large and complex implies that the paths of their mind down the timelines are a branching tree. A complex observer's mind also needs to be close to an unbroken path in the event tree, so information being theoretically available affects the path that an observer's mind can take. We've called that timeline selection. This is different to the traditional single time-dimensional view of physics. Here are some of the differences. In a 1D time world, particles have uncertainty and are in a probability cloud until they're observed. In a multi-D time world, particles are in well-defined places and the uncertainty is in the mind of multiple copies of the observers. In a 1D time world, some events appear random and can only be described statistically. In a multi-D time world, everything possible happens and there is no randomness. In a 1D time world, particles are in the state of superposition and their wave function collapses when they're observed. In a multi-D time world, particles are in specific states, but the minds of observers in different timelines are in sync with each other until they each observe the particle in a different state. In a 1D time world, pairs of particles can be entangled where observing one instantaneously determines the state of the other. In a multi-D time world, all particle pair combinations exist, and the observations make the mind states of the observers diverge with no effect at all on the particles. Multiple time dimensions are also different to the many worlds interpretation of quantum physics. In many worlds, the entire universe branches for unknown reasons every time there's a quantum event. The branching and diverging mind states are a consequence of multiple time dimensions and not arbitrarily postulated rules. There are other interesting effects to investigate in the context of multiple time dimensions, such as quantum tunneling. Also, we want to know if we can devise experiments to test whether our hypothesis about multiple time dimensions is correct. We will get to these in the next video.